What's up, guys? This is Ninja wearing aviators under Superman hat, bringing you another episode on the Modern Ninja Channel. Here we are going over Fight Like Red Hood. Let's go.
Dick trusted me, but you never will.
Someone's desperate for approval.
I've got more than enough father figures.
So, like, I'm gonna be starting a lot of these videos. For those of you that don't know what this series is, this series, we take a character, whether it's from comics, video games, movies, real life, doesn't matter where, we take a character, go through their personal fighting style, and I show you how you can train to be like that character. In this episode, obviously, we are going over Red Hood, so let's get started, because this is my favorite X-Robin, I guess? Post-Robin? Whatever. This is my favorite apprentice of Batman. So Red Hood is very effective and quick when he takes out enemies. He doesn't waste time throwing meaningless punches or meaningless kicks that don't really take out the enemy. They just kind of stun them. Red Hood doesn't really do that. He does very quick, very decisive moves to be able to take down an enemy in 3 to 5 moves per target. And so when you're taking down, you know, countless enemies, that becomes super helpful. Now, part of that is Red Hood's willingness to kill. And so, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying killing is a good thing. Killing is not the greatest answer to any question. But if, you know, you're surrounded by 50 guys with bats and knives, then you got to do what you got to do to survive. So whenever you're practicing your martial arts techniques that you're learning, if things are super dangerous, that is useful in this situation, because Red Hood is one person, one dude with no powers. You got to be able to put enemies down quickly so you can survive long enough to finish the fight, because I guarantee you there are 50 guys attacking you. They will beat you unless, you know, you put them down with the gun that you're carrying as Red Hood. Now, as far as fighting goes, Red Hood uses his hands and feet fairly equally in his fighting style. He uses his hands maybe a little bit more than his feet, but they still are used to compensate or to enhance each other. He'll use a kick to set up a good hand beatdown, or use a punch to set up a good kick takedown. He is very good at using both of those things together to take down his enemies. He's not limiting himself, which is really good, because you can't afford to limit himself. But one thing to know is that when he uses his hands, it's not often, I mean, it can be punches and chops and stuff like that. He knows how to do that. But it's often using the hilt of the gun, because guess what's harder than your bones? Metal. And so since he carries around two modified Jericho 19 or 941s, pretty sure they're Jericho 941s, he uses the hilt of the metal gun to do the damage. So that means one hit to the face with a punch you can take, but one hit to the head with the metal handle of a gun, not so much. That's what's going to allow him to be able to come up and finish off his targets relatively quickly, because he doesn't just punch people with his hands. He uses weapons at all times. And so that's something to keep in mind when you are practicing to fight like Red Hood, that you have to be able to use the weapons you are given at all times. Red Hood is also very, very proficient at using knives. So whether it's throwing stars and being able to kind of distract the enemy or do some minor annoying damage to the enemy, or using like an actual knife to be able to fight his way through, cut ropes, and just, you know, knife combat is incredibly useful. And something you need to keep in mind when you're practicing Red Hood combat is that when you're practicing like Red Hood, you have to use weapons, and knives are definitely a part of that list. But there's some things you have to be careful of when you're practicing them, because they're knives. They can cut you just as easily as they can cut your enemy. So when you practice them, be careful always use safety precautions to practice. Always use dull knives to practice so that, you know, if you mess up, you don't, you know, kill yourself. Now, Red Hood is acrobatic as a Robin, especially as a Robin. He's very acrobatic, just like all the Robins are. They seem to always need some acrobatics. But as he gets older, he relies less on the flashier acrobatics and more on the power he gets from his legs, whether that's jumping over or through people to get a better shot on them, or even being able to survive falls and rolling out, things like that. Simple, less flashy parkour parkour techniques are going to be very useful for being able to pull off the things that Red Hood can pull off. Jumping and falling from rooftops, or jumping across rooftops, you're going to be able to need some powerful legs to be able to jump from one end to the other. So make sure you are practicing rolling out, jumping around, practice, you know, flips, because you need that leg strength to be able to apply it to your other fighting scenarios. Lastly, which I'm not going to cover in full depth here, if you want me to cover in full depth, then that can be for a separate video some other time, but he uses his guns, and he's smart at how he uses his guns. He knows where his kill shots are. He knows where wounding locations are, and he's good at using his guns to complete a task. So maybe he was fighting, you know, he's fighting a Robin that he doesn't want to kill, but he wants to subdue. He won't shoot them. He'll shoot next to them, rattling their ears. Or maybe he's trying to take some bad guy down so he can interrogate them. You know, certain areas of the leg shots you can shoot, certain areas in the arm and stuff that you can shoot without them bleeding out and stuff like that. It is very important for you to go through, and it's too much to go through into right now. I'm not going to do it right now, but do some Google searching to know where your blood vessels are, where the kill points are, where the where all the individual pressure points are, and major arteries are in the body, so that you know where's, you know, survivable and where's not survivable. Because being able to tell the difference and knowing the difference ahead of time before you make your action is incredibly important, because not knowing could be the difference of, you know, life and death, literally the difference of life and death. So with Red Hood, you really have to know the stuff you're talking about. You really have to know your stuff, because if you don't, it can be very bad. All right, now it's going to be the best part of the video, just like before, where we go into your own some combos that you can learn and practice at home, where you can practice to be like Red Hood.
So I'm not going to be using guns, because I'm kind of in a public place in a city where I don't, you know, want to be assumed I'm holding a gun in random places. So instead, I want you to imagine I'm holding two guns in my hand, because that's just how this is going to work. Sorry about that. That's just how the cookie crumbles. So with that said, imagine I am holding two guns in my face. So I'm going to, in my hand. So I'm going to start off here. 1 second. I hate when cars pass at really inopportune moments. Anyway, so we're going to start off here. We're going to come in with the back of the left-handed gun and into the face. We're going to stun them, right hitting that hinge of the jaw, possibly breaking the jaw. So bang, right there with the back of the hilt into the face, the hinge of the jaw, cracking that jaw. And then this, your right hand is going to sweep underneath, bang, that leg, shooting, sweeping the close leg and shooting the far leg so that they fall to the ground, right? So that they get to the ground, because you don't want them standing. So one more time, back of the or side of the head, sweeping one leg, shooting the other so they can hit the ground, taking that right hand that you just sweeped with, going across the face and finishing just like that. So one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4. Just like that. I say just like that too often in this video too. Jeez, I'm gonna try to stop that. So all together. Bang. One more time. So this is going to be more of an interrogation style of combination. So this one's not going to be quite as deadly as the last one, but this will be basically putting them down so that you can interrogate them while they're still breathing. And again, why is it that there's a car that always drives past when I start recording every single one of these clips. I don't understand it. Anyway, so again, imagine you have those guns in those hands. You're gonna let them come up to you, throwing that a right-armed hook punch at your face, and you're going to block their punch. Just block the inside of their punch. Now, you're going to crack with your right hand the side of their jaw, again, hitting the hinge of their jaw, breaking that jaw, or hitting the skull, cracking their skull, giving them a concussion, which would also be very helpful. So again, block, crack. Now you're going to use your right hand and wrap it around their neck and hold them up just so they start choking and start freaking out so you have control. And then you're going to take your left hand and cap their knee just like that. So it goes block, crack, grab up, knee shot. All together, bang. So for our last combination, just like I said before, I can't really use a real knife out here just because it's public and I don't want to get in trouble for anything like that because I like recording here and I don't want to have to find a new location. So with that said, I'm going to use this as my makeshift knife. And I just want you to imagine it's a knife. So here we go. We have no gun, just a knife. This combination is going to start out here. You're going to let them come to you. They're going to swing across with that left hook coming at your head. Now what you're going to do is you're going to duck underneath, swipe at the leg. Just like that. You're going to duck underneath, swipe at the leg. You're going to, and after that swipe at the leg, stab the ribs. And you can stab it and leave it in there, stab, pull out, doesn't really matter. So you're going to duck underneath, swipe at the legs, stab the under the rib cage right there. One more time, duck, swipe, stab. You're going to grab, knee them in the chest, knee them right in the solar plexus to get them out of breath. So one, two, three. You're going to then finish them off with that right hook, dropping them onto the ground. They're done. And so just like this is all together, it's gonna be one, two, three, four. Just like that. All together fast. One, two, bang.
I hope you enjoyed this episode of Fight Like a Superhero. I love Red Hood. He is my favorite of the X-Robins. And I just, you know, I love being able to watch him. I love being able to practice like him, train like him, stuff like that. So if you liked him too, and if you like this video, definitely leave a like and let me know, because it makes me want to make more videos just like this, or even better, hopefully better in the future. Hopefully I'm always getting better at these. But so with all that said, just guys, be careful. Make sure you're always safe and always smart. Don't just go around willy-nilly and, you know, stabbing people, because that's not good. That's not what these videos are for. These videos are for making you being your fighting styles like you want them. If you want to fight like Red Hood, this is what you need to do. With all that said, if you enjoy these videos, make sure to subscribe and leave a like to let me know that I'm doing good. And if you have any characters you want me to do in the future, let me know down in the comments, whether it's, you know, Daredevil or Black Panther. I think I already did Black Panther though. Daredevil or Punisher or heck, even Superman. If you wanted to do Superman, I would do Superman for you guys. So let me know what you want to see me do in the future. Until next time, my name's DJ Moore. This is the Modern Ninja, and I'm out.